By the year 2020, most European OEMs will have 48-volt hybrid systems. This will help to reduce the carbon emissions by 15%, which is great for the environment, but poses certain challenges for the automotive industry. Hi, my name is Don LaFontaine. I'm an application engineer here with Intersil, and I'm joined by Ed Kohler, who's our Senior Marketing Manager for the Automotive Group. Ed, thanks for joining.
Thanks, Don. It's a pleasure to be here.
So, Ed, can you tell us about the trends in the automotive power and some of the challenges?
Sure. As you mentioned, manufacturers are trying to introduce 48-volt hybrid systems, and that requires a 48-volt power system. They're doing that to improve fuel efficiency, reduce CO2 emissions, all while not negatively impacting the driver experience.
And so does this add a lot of cost?
Not necessarily. The OEMs have been very careful about how they added the 48-volt net. So rather than replacing wholesale all of the electronics to run from 48 volts, they add the 48 volts as an incremental addition to the system. Of course, that does necessitate a bidirectional bridge between the 12 and 48 volt systems, but in general, it's a relatively low cost adder.
Okay, so how's that done?
Well, the bidirectional bridge is important. It's got to be able to transfer energy from 48 down to 12 in some circumstances and 12 back up to 48 in others. One way to do that is with a DSP, a digital solution, so sort of like the digital power techniques that we see in industry today. Another way is to take two unidirectional controllers and wire them up so that each one manages one of those two flows. So there's a couple of different ways to do it.
So that increases design time, board space, and of course cost?
Well, it did, and that's why we developed the ISIL 78226, the industry's first six-phase bidirectional DC to DC controller. So we combined the flexibility of the digital or DSP-based solution with the simplicity of an analog solution, while we keep in mind the overall challenges of the system. So a single IC can manage energy transfer or power transfer from both the 12 to 48 volt direction or 48 down to 12, and it can even manage abrupt changes in direction if that's needed by the vehicle.
You mentioned the overall system challenges. What are they, and how does this part solve them?
It's a good question. So the board, or the system, has to be able to transfer power from 12 to 48 in some circumstances and 48 to 12 in others. So it's bidirectional. It has to be very efficient because the loads are up to 3.5 kilowatts. So the first thing that we did was design this as a controller, so that way it can sit in the relatively quiet area. It's the brains of the system, so you don't want it being corrupted by all of the noisy switching events. Then we allowed the drivers and the FETs and the power stage to all be distributed around the board. That allows us to keep all of that noise away from the sensitive portions of the circuit. You'll notice that there are six phases on this board. The 78226 controller can manage up to six phases. It'll automatically adjust from anywhere between two and six phases so that it can maximize the efficiency for the given load at any time. It also regulates the voltage, which you need for DC to DC conversion, while also regulating the maximum current allowed. That protects all of the power stages as well as the vehicle power systems. Finally, we added some additional features for the system. So we have a flyback converter that will create the power supplies for the FET drivers. And we also have integrated an auxiliary linear regulator to supply all the digital secondary functions.
You mentioned it regulates both voltage and current. Is this limited to one set point?
No, definitely not. Both can be adjusted on the fly. The output voltage can be changed with either an analog control signal or a digital PWM signal, and the maximum current can be adjusted through the digital interface.
So is this digital power?
No, not really. I mean, we have an analog controller, so you don't need to write any of the complex firmware you'd need if you were trying to control the loops digitally. But we do offer, if you want to use it, a digital interface called PMBus. That makes it really easy to communicate with the setup functions and the diagnostic capability of the part.
Great, so what is the efficiency of this product?
Well, we can easily achieve over 95% for loads up to 3.5 kilowatts.
So safety and reliability is a big concern. Have you done anything to address this?
Yes, absolutely. In automotive, ISO 26262 places a big emphasis on fault coverage for functional safety. The ISIL 78226 includes a significant amount of diagnostic capability, both for the IC itself and for the overall system. And all this information can be communicated back to a system controller via the PMBus interface. So in that way, we've really helped to improve the overall fault coverage and the functional safety that can be achieved with this system.
Great. So what kind of tools do you have for the customer to use this thing?
Well, we offer this reference design for a 12 to 48 volt converter up to 3 kilowatts and 95% efficiency. It comes with a GUI interface to talk to the part through the PMBus interface, and all of that's available for order or download off of our website. So please visit us at intersil.com/products/ISL78226.
Great, this is exciting news for the automotive industry. I'd like to thank Ed for his time and joining us today. And thank you for watching.